there, my lovelies. This is Jana here. Welcome to my kitchen. Another dish for the holidays. And it's an interesting one because it's easy. As always. And it is a dish that it's usually enjoyed during the Easter holidays in Brazil. It's a dish that involves fish, codfish. And we're not going to use fish, we're going to use something to substitute it. It's going to be even better because I will teach you a way to make your fish substitute to get these sea flavors, you know, that sea umami. The point is, it's delicious. I know I get carried away because I get excited because I love my recipe, so it's a good thing. Let me show you how I put it together. So, you see the ingredients here? We have potatoes, garlic, peppers, onions, and the star of the show. We have oyster mushrooms. Oh, but I can't find oyster mushrooms. No problem. You just use any mushroom you have available, and you slice it into bite-sized pieces. With the oyster mushrooms, we're going to shred it. I'll show you so they don't get so big because they're supposed to be into bite-sized pieces, okay? And we're going to marinate it in these sea flavors umami broth. And here's how I made it. You take a jug or a mason jar or a deep dish, and then you're going to put the mushrooms shredded, like I said, and any seaweed you have at home, either kelp, wakame, sea lettuce, what else, nori, whatever you have, whatever you prefer, okay? They all have that sea flavors that we're looking for. And then garlic powder, onion powder, white pepper, and fill it with water. Now we close it, mix it up a little bit or shake it, put it in the fridge for up to 48 hours. And now we're going to make a marinade for the vegetables with white pepper, onion powder, garlic powder, salt, and olive oil. A little bit of the olive oil juice and a little bit of the mushrooms marinate. Now I have here pre-cooked potato. That potato you saw, I peeled, sliced it into 1 centimeter thick, and I pre-cooked it. And now we're going to slice all the vegetables same thickness, 1 centimeter, because they're going in the oven, and if they're too thin, they're going to disappear. We need texture, okay? We need not only flavor, we need texture along with the food. So put it in a plate or a dish or a Dutch oven, any way you like. And now we're going to add that marinade that we did with the olive oil all over, okay? And now we're going to put in the oven at 200 degrees Celsius. That will be 398 degrees Fahrenheit, if I'm not mistaken. 400, okay? Let's round it, 400, for about 30 minutes. You know your oven, so keep an eye on it. We don't want the mushrooms. We don't want the vegetables to shrink too much. Your house, by the way, is going to be smelling like paradise. It's the other thing about this dish, it's not a heavy, although it has olive oil, because it's a Portuguese inspired, I forgot to mention that. It's a Portuguese inspired dish, and in Portugal, they love their olive oil, and they should, because it's amazing. So, although it has quite a bit of olive oil, it's a light dish with all the vegetables. So 10 minutes before you turn off the oven, you remove the dish. You fry the potatoes, simple. You fry until they're golden brown. You know what I did? As always, I don't know how to cook if it's not to cook for the whole church. I have this missing in my brain. When I cook, I cook a lot. That's what I did, because I always think that it's not gonna be enough. So much so that halfway through, I put more mushrooms in the marinade, in the fridge. But it's okay, because then I had two recipes. It was too much, okay? And I wanted to do a nice presentation, and I don't want it to make more fried potatoes, so I put it in a smaller plate. Now, you don't need to transfer everything to another plate. The reason I did that is because I didn't have enough potatoes to put on top of my pot there. So you just remove the pot from the oven, put the fried potatoes on top, and serve it. How about that? You guys, seriously, during these holidays, I wanted to pop you drinking water. Okay, that's the noise. So, during this holiday season, I wanted to make recipes that they were going to taste amazing, a little bit sui generis in the sense of a little bit different than the trivial, than the traditional, because it's nice. It's nice, the tradition, that every year we make the same thing, but it's also nice to make something different, to wow people and yourself. That's what the festivities are about, right? So I wanted to do that. However, I wanted to keep the budget down because it's fun to do that. You feel better. I feel better. It's the same feeling as when you find a very good wine at an affordable price. I think that you enjoy it even more. I don't know. I have this thing. And so this beauty here, you're going to love it. You have to make it. Please, Poppy, don't mess with the camera. She was going through the, how do you call it, the tripod legs. And I was like, she's gonna mess it. Okay, she didn't, because she can't see anymore. She's 16. She's an old lady. She's not an old lady. She's a little bit old. All right, no more babbling. The Brazilians in the house, are you representing? Let me know if you remember, of course you remember, but let me know if you used to have that during Easter. That was my dad's favorite because he was just like, put it all together and put it in the oven. He thought that he was the best cook ever. So this is it, guys. Have a wonderful week and see you next time. Bye-bye.